Hello everyone, it's Sarah with Spicy Pinecone, and today I'm doing a little experiment. After my last batch, I had a lot of piping batter left over, and I don't like to waste batter, so I just went ahead and piped it onto a piece of paper and set it aside for it to kind of, you know, harden up and set. And I started to wonder, like, maybe I could use it as little soap samples or maybe something else, put it on top of another loaf. But the more that I thought about it, the more I wanted to use it inside of a loaf of soap, kind of like an embed. And I'm still not sure if I want to cut the finished bar or the finished loaf vertically or if I want to slice it horizontally. Honestly, this is just a shot in the dark, trying something to use up extra soap scraps. So what I've done is I went ahead and prepped my loaf with the first layer of little squiggle embeds, and I also have the main part of my soap waiting off to the side for the lye solution to cool down. And I did use the same recipe, so it's not going to get complicated whenever I have to label it. So when I first started thinking of colors to use for the main portion of the batter, I knew that I didn't want to use anything that was in the embeds. I didn't want pink, purple, blue, or white, because then you wouldn't see the contrast. They would just kind of disappear into the main part of the soap. So then I thought of black, but that was a little too severe for the fragrance oil, I felt. So instead, I'm going with this kind of light gray that I've mixed up, and it's going to become even lighter because the lye solution has titanium dioxide. So I'm just going to kind of play with the colors as I go and see about how dark or light. I may have to add more mica to it later to darken it up, but we will just have to see. Okay, so my lye has cooled down enough and I'm ready to add it to my oils. And once again, if you look down in there, I have some titanium dioxide just to lighten the entire batch up. So as you can see, it lightened up a lot when I added that titanium dioxide, and I want a little bit more color. So I've got some gray mica here, and I'm just going to go ahead and add a little bit at a time. Okay, so I'm happy with this color right here, and I'm going to go ahead and add my fragrance. All right, moment of truth. Now I'm just going to pour it in. Okay, so I'm just jiggling it around and I'm going to go whack it a few times to try to get some air bubbles out. Okay, so I hit it on the ground for a while and a lot of air bubbles came out and they're still kind of coming up. There's a part of me tempted to take the rest of my embeds and throw it into the batter, but I'm still going to stick to, whoop, kind of the plan, and just stick the rest of these in there by hand and see how it goes. Thank you. so here it is, and it doesn't look like much from here. It doesn't look like it really has anything going on, but I hit it on the ground a bunch of times to get rid of the air bubbles. There were a lot of air bubbles. I had to whack it a lot, but I believe I've gotten most of them out. I'll be able to tell once I cut it. So I'm going to let it sit for 24 to 48 hours and then slice it up. It has been about 48 hours and I've unmolded the soap. It is ready to cut. I am really, really excited and kind of nervous actually to cut this one. I have no idea what it's going to look like. Usually with my soap batches, I have at least some idea. So what I figured I would do is I would cut one bar vertically and then see what it looked like. And then I want to cut it vertically again, but then horizontally, and then open it up and see what that looks like. This, like I said, this batch is an experiment. I have no idea what it's going to look like, if it's going to look cool or kind of crazy, but I guess we'll see. Weird. Okay. That looks like butterfly fairy things. That is so, okay, I did not really expect that. I kind of expected like some squiggles going up, but that looks, okay, that's kind of cool. Can you see? Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this. I've already pre-measured how much this would be, and I have my loaf slicer set up to cut about a chunk like this, and then bring it back over here and cut it horizontally. Okay, so here you can see the big chunk that I've cut, and now what I'm going to do is cut it like that. Okay, that looks like flowers. Can you see that? Okay, so here is a comparison. This is the one that was cut vertically, and you can see it's honestly they kind of look pretty similar. I think I like the ones that are cut horizontally more, just because when you look at the sides, you've got decoration or squiggles, little flower looking things on the sides as well. And these will look better after I've set them aside and clean them up a bit. But I think what I'm going to do is cut the rest of the batch horizontally. I like the flowers on the side a little bit more than just having it on one side. Okay, so here they are. They are all cut. I still have to go through and clean them up, but it looks like a garden. It is just, I am super, super excited about this technique and I want to try it again. So it's a great way to use up extra soap batter and it looks like a garden. Thank you guys so much for watching. It was a very fun experiment. I hope you guys enjoyed.